welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss about the model building and verification and validation. So in this model building, we should know some features about this before going to this. So this is nothing but it is a process of representing a model which includes its construction and working. And this model is similar to the real system, which helps the analyst predict the effect of changes to the system. So modeling is creating a model which represents a system including their properties, and it is an act of building a model. So in this, the analyst is going to predict the existing, with the existing system to get the accurate results of simulation, because simulation will be very difficult to it is very difficult to interpret a result. Then in this model building, we do have a real system, and we are going to apply various modeling techniques in the real system based on the parameters. And simulation of a system is the operation of a model in terms of time or space, which helps analyze the performance of an existing or a proposed system. So in other words, simulation is a process of using a model to study the performance of a system. So it is an act of using model for simulation. So when we're talking about the simulation, we have an historical chronological order is starting from 1940 onwards, and then one by one will be seen. So model building. So in this model building, the verification and validation process is included, and the process consists of the following components. And verification is concerned with building the model right, and validation is concerned with building the right model. So this includes the verification and validation. The analyst is going to predict with the historical aspects. The thing is, first of all, we have to prepare before going to this verification and validation, we need to prepare a problem statement and choose the input variables and create entities for the simulation process. And there are two types of variables. One is decision variables and uncontrollable variables. So decision variables are controlled by the programmer, and uncontrollable variables are the random variables. So we are going to create a constraints on the decision variables by assigning into the simulation process, and afterwards we are going to determine the output variables. And we can collect data from the real life system to input into the simulation, because so many concepts, we are going to apply the null hypothesis testing on the input data distribution. In that, we do have a technique called acceptance and rejection technique. So these things we can overcome through this model building. And in this model building, we do have an analyst, and he is going to analyze the performance of a system through the verification and validation. For example, if verification, if our project or product is in an accurate or appropriate manner, then we can give a proper example for the verification. And validation is nothing but whether it is correct requirements or not. So that is the way we can, it is just building the right model. So in this, we can see the phenomenon, how it is going to be a process. So first of all, we have a real system. In this, we have a conceptual validation and calibration and validation. We have a model called conceptual model, and then operation model. In this conceptual model, we are going to assume on the system components and structural assumptions which define the interaction between the system components. Input parameters and data assumptions will be applicable in the conceptual model. And in the operational model, we have a computerized representation. So in this operational model, we are going to, based on the computerized demography, we are doing all the operations in this model. So we have a calibration and validation also. So first of all, we have a basic concepts of this model building. First of all, an object. It is an entity which exists in the real world to study the behavior of a model. First of all, before going to these kind of conceptual model and model verification, we need to have a real system, and we are going to apply the process. That is our main objective. And base model. So in this base model, this is the hypothetical explanation of object properties and its behavior, which is valid across the model. So what are the properties which is related to the object is matters a lot. And afterwards, we can go for experimental frame. So in this, we are going to study a system in the real world, like experimental conditions, aspects and objectives. Like we can say frame, it consists of two sets of variables. One is frame input variables and frame output variables, which matches the system components or not. So next is verification. So it's verification is nothing but we can say we already discussed about this verification. It's like it is concerned with building the model right. So in this verification, this is a process of comparing two or more items to ensure their accuracy in modeling and simulation. Verification can be done by comparing the consistency of a simulation program and the lumped model to ensure their performance. So there are various ways to perform the validation process, which we'll cover in separate chapter. And when we're talking about the validation, so this is the process of comparing two results in modeling and simulation as it is. It is performed by comparing experiment measurements with the simulation results within a context of experimental frame. So the model is invalid if the results mismatch. There are various ways to perform validation process, which we'll cover in separate one. So before going to these things, first of all, we do have a real system. In that real system, the analyst is going to he is going to predict the things with the existing one, and then afterwards we can move to the conceptual model and the operational model. So in this, before going to these models, we need to know what is verification and what is validation, and we are going to assume the things on the conceptual model and the computerized related data on the operational model. Now steps involved in this previous slide. So first of all, the step one, observe the real system and interaction among its various components and collect data on its behavior. The second thing is a collection of, this is about the conceptual model. So in this, a collection of assumptions on the components and the structure of the system plus hypothesis on the values of model input parameters. So the third step is operational model. So this is usually by using the simulation software and incorporating the assumptions of the conceptual model into the worldview and concepts of simulation software. The main purpose of model verification is to ensure the conceptual model, and it is reflected accurately in the operational model. See, whatever the assumptions we are applying in the conceptual model is reflected accurately in the operational model, which is computer related. The conceptual model is quite often involves some degree of abstraction about the system operations or some amount of simplification of the actual operations. And verification asks the following question, like it is, is the conceptual model accurately represented by the operational model? So this is how. So when we see the classification of the models, we do have a various categories like discrete event simulation, stochastic versus deterministic system, and static dynamics, or discrete and continuous, like this. So we'll see the one by one. When we're talking about the discrete event simulation model, the state variable value changes only at some discrete points in time where the events occur. So events will only occur at the defined activity times and delays. And then stochastic, when we're talking about the stochastic, it is like probabilistic. So these are not affected by randomness, and their output is not a random variable. Various deterministic systems are affected by randomness, and their output is a random variable. When we see this discrete and continuous system, so many distributions can be assumed in this, both either a discrete and the continuous. So this is affected by the state variable changes as discrete point of time, and its behavior is depicted in the following graphical representation. There is an we already saw in the previous slides and all. And modeling process, how it happens. First of all, in this diagram we already discussed, examine the problem first of all, and then in this stage we must understand the problem and then and choose its classification accordingly, like deterministic or stochastic. And then we have to take step to design a model. We have to perform the following simple tasks, like collect the information as per the system behavior and the future requirements, and analyze the system features and its assumptions and necessary actions to make the model to be successful. And now we will see many common sense suggestions can be given for use in the verification process. Someone has to check the model, whether it is working or not. Make a flow diagram that it is easy for all the one to analyze things. Make a flow diagram that includes each logically possible action a system can take when an event occurs. And we can closely examine the model output for reasonableness under a variety of input parameter settings. And at last, what we have to do is we have to print the input parameters at the end of simulation, make sure they have not been changed inadvertently. So and then afterwards we can make the operational model as self documenting as possible. If the operational model is animated, verify that what is seen in the animation, it imitates the actual system. What is actual system? over here. So, and then we can say the debugger. Debugger is going to correct the errors which is having a problems. And then we can say this debugger as interactive run controller also we can say. So this is an essential component of successful simulation model building. Even the best of simulation analyst makes mistakes or commits logical errors when building a model. So the IRC assists in finding and correcting those errors in the following ways. And simulation can be monitored as its progress. So in this, attention can be focused on a particular line of logic or multiple lines of logic that it constitutes a procedure or a particular entity. So values of selected model components can be observed. Normally we have an observation frequently, and counting or records, everything is happening frequently. When the simulation has passed, the current value or status of the variable or attributes, queues, resources, counters can be observed, because observation will be happening frequently in the simulation concept. So the simulation can be temporarily suspended not only to view the information but also to reassign values or redirect the entities. So here graphical user interface are recommended for accomplishing the verification and validation. So now we can see the real system, and we can apply all the concept wherever it is applicable, and then we can find out the solution for this. Thank you.